don't need no reason why. Come on, come on.
For today's video, I'm going to be doing a fall makeup look. I know I look dead right now. I haven't put on makeup in 7 whole days. Like, maybe more than that. Because I had off the hurricane starting Thursday. So I literally haven't put on makeup in forever. So I kind of look dead right now. And I'm going to be doing my makeup today. My goal is to try to make like a fall-y, like orangey, ready, like makeup look. Also, the reason why I'm not filming by my bed is because that whole side of my room got destroyed in the hurricane. There's literally a hole in the ceiling, but for some reason this part of my room is like fine, so that's where I'm filming my videos. Yeah, I think I can get into the thing now. I look so dead. I think I'm gonna first do my eyebrows. I feel like the eyebrows and the eyelashes just make you look more alive, and I feel like really dead right now. The Anastasia medium browed power duo. I feel like this is such a bad setup, and I just feel like my videos are so unprofessional if they're not in my filming setup that was like all cute, you know. I put some fairy lights on this, so I think it looks kind of cuter, but I just feel like it's just weird lighting. Okay, so now that I have like eyebrows-ish, I'm gonna be doing my eyelashes because I feel like that makes you look more awake. Okay, so I'm gonna be using all of these to put on my lashes. But yeah, I feel like I could put on all of these mascaras, and I still don't have long eyelashes. Like, they need to make false lashes for small eyes, because like, I don't know, my eyes look small and they just don't fit on the thing sometimes, and I cut them and they just look fake, you know. I just need some like good natural looking false lashes for small eyes. I'm back with like semi long eyelashes, like not really, but like longer than before, I guess. If you guys have any good mascara suggestions that like really make your eyelashes pop, you should like send them to me, because I just like not satisfied with the length of my eyelashes. I might do another coat of all those things and like maybe that will make them better, but I'm just not satisfied. I just want long lashes. It's not working out. So I'm gonna go on to foundation and concealer right now. Probably the first thing that most people would have started with, but I just didn't want to. Okay, so for concealer, because usually I put my foundation on before I put my concealer on, but you know, today I just want to change it. So literally, okay, this is a Tarte Shape Tape concealer. I swear to you, it never comes off. Like, you could literally be in like a wrestling match and then like get thrown in the pool and then like go through like a tornado and then like go back into the ocean, but like all your other makeup is gonna be gone, but like this will never leave you. Like, it's literally so hard to wash off. But yeah, so I'm gonna put that on all the places where like your makeup starts to fade throughout the day and it kind of gets like red. That's where I'm gonna put on. It just never leaves. Like, I know it's not gonna wear out because it never leaves. And then I'm gonna put my foundation on top. Is that caking my face? Kind of, yeah. That was way too much. I'm gonna regret that. All right, that's the, I just dripped some of it. Okay, that's the main places. So my makeup wears off on my foundation. I put a ton on. I'm gonna definitely regret this. I have an acne breakout on my chin. And I don't know why, because I literally haven't put on makeup in a day, and it never happened when I put on makeup. See, I look like a ghost now. My skin is way too white. I put on way too much concealer. You know what I should do? I should get one in like my actual face color. Or why did I not get one in my actual face color before? I don't know. Maybe, is there a, like a dumb question? Okay, so for foundation, I'm gonna be using the L'Oreal True Match Super Blendable Makeup. Oh well. Okay, so I'm gonna be using my foundation. But anyways, I actually haven't been to Sephora in like since March, I think, is the last time I went there. I could be wrong. I think March is the last time I bought anything from Sephora. So you guys should be so proud of me, because I used to go there a lot, and I used to spend a lot of money, and I've got a lot of makeup now. But I haven't been there in a while. But I do kind of want to go back just so I can get a new foundation, I guess, because I've been using this one from like Walgreens for a while. But I haven't shopped there in a month. So I'm basically like a good hoarder now, because I've been not hoarding. Does it make sense? All right, I don't know. I'm gonna put on my foundation now. Honestly, for people who say you can't put the foundation back in the foundation bottle, watch me. I just put it back in. I mean, it's dripping out a little bit, but you know, it's mostly there. Like, I just put it back in. Honestly, I don't think anyone said that quote I just said. This is way too much foundation. why do I use so much makeup? Why can't I just be a little minimalistic person? That makes no sense. So now that I have my foundation on, I'm gonna put a powder that is way darker so it actually kind of matches my body. My face kind of will match my body after this, maybe. Okay, so this is my powder and it is from Milani. So another thing, I haven't even spent that much on a powder because this one is from Walgreens. Also, I've had this one for years and I do have some Sephora ones, but I need this one to like darken up my face because, okay, so now that I have my powder on and it looks like a semi-close color, it's gonna look better after I do this step. So I'm going to be using my bronzer, which is the Too Faced Fake Luminescence Glow Bronzer. And I'm going to be way over bronzing my face so that it looks all contour and it also looks like it matches my skin a little bit better because I'm still like a little bit darker than my face right now. And I'm just going to sculpt it way out, make it look like I have cheekbones, make it look like I'm not just like one big moon emoji. That's what I'm going to be doing. It's going to look nice, kind of. And yeah, this is like the best brush in the history of brushes. It's the Luxe 504 Large Angle Brush. It looks like Luxe-y though, but I feel like I've heard people say Luxe brushes before. Honestly, I don't know. I didn't go out to the store and buy this myself. It was sent to me in a subscription box. So yeah. Also, I'm gonna have to do my mascara again because it looks all gross now. Oh no, I just put it on way too much. Well, that's like an everyday routine for me. I kind of was just like looking at the camera. I feel like, oh well, you know. The lighting in this area of my room is so weird. I think it's because all the lighting is coming from the back of me because I've got these and I have a window up there. So yeah, the lighting in the side of my room is so weird. Now I'm going to be using my blush, which is the Tarte Color Imparte. This is the blush that comes with the birthday present of this year. You know, if you get like, you go to your birthday on Sephora, you get a little free gift. This is the one that comes with that. But you know, this one's actually like a really good color. If it's your birthday soon, you should go set up your Sephora account so you can get the present, or if it's makeup a birthday, if you don't have it, because it's honestly like so cute. Yeah, I think it's like my favorite blush ever. I'm applying this with the De Real Technique blushing brush. I don't really apply a highlighter that much because I feel like my face is already oily and like shiny, so I just kind of don't apply it. Okay, so now I'm gonna be applying more like mascaras because my mascara is kind of grossed up, so I'm gonna apply more mascaras and then I'm gonna come back and then I'm gonna do all the orangey like fall-y stuff and it's gonna be all cute, hopefully. I don't really know, I've never tried this before, this is gonna be my first trial, and yeah, we'll see. Okay, so I'm done, so you can get into the fall stuff. Also, I'm gonna name this big old zit because I'm like looking at him through the viewfinder this like whole video. I think we should name him like Arma instead of Irma because everyone was commenting on my last video that I was saying it and it sounded more like Arma instead of Irma. So yeah, I'm gonna be naming it Arma for people making fun of how I say my words, I guess. Yeah, okay. So I have a whole bunch of palettes here. Kind of like a yellow color that I thought we could maybe use. And there's this color. Most of my like normal palettes are like browns and stuff, but I have all these ones that have weird colors. So there's these reds that I can use. This one has an orange and like a red and a yellow. So I don't really know what we're gonna do right now. Honestly, I really don't know. I think I'm just gonna try to put a bunch of colors on and just like see what it looks like. Probably not the best idea. Okay, by the way, my camera set off, so I don't know if you heard, but I'm using a yellowy color right now. I'm also using this as a mirror just because the mirror is bigger and better. Bigger is better. So I think I might go on to this orange as the next one because it's kind of like a subtly orange. That's what I'm gonna go for. I'm gonna use the same weird brush. I don't really know why. That's just kind of what I'm feeling right now, is using the, like, weird brush. Okay, so I have like a peachy look going on. So I'm gonna start using my oranges. I don't really know if this is gonna turn out good. Hopefully it does. More of like a darker orange than the orange that I'm using before. It's still not really a dark orange. I hope it shows up though. These colors really aren't pigmented too well. Okay, so I think I'm gonna start using some like reds to like bring in the fall-y look because it doesn't look like too fall-y right now. We're gonna try to get that fall makeup look be that real beauty guru. Like, it's called a headstrong. I don't know why. All right, so now we're gonna blend that out because that looks kind of in right now. I should try, would this be kind of an orangey color or like not? Like this whimsy one, I don't know. I kind of want to make it more orangey. So you know what, I might try it. I might use more of like browns because I feel like it definitely doesn't look fall-ish enough for me. I just want it to look fall. That's all I want. So yeah, I think I'm gonna add some browns. Also feel like I might do my eyebrows again. They look like light. I don't know. I just feel like it's a blonde hair problem. Your eyebrows will always look light. You just can't do anything about it. Unless if you made them black, but then that would look really weird. Yeah, that one just wouldn't fit with my face. Okay, so I'm gonna be edgy, I think, on my outer corner to try to make it look more fallish, fall vibes. That's what it looks like right now. Does it look fallish to you? Because I just feel, I'm just not feeling fall. I'm just getting like the springtime vibes from this. I'm gonna put on some lipstick. We'll see if that makes me feel more fall. I'm using this red color. It is a ColourPop Ultra Makeup Matte, Ultra Matte Lip. Where's the color? Love Bug. It's gonna be in Love Bug. I literally look like some of it's messed up over here and I literally look like it just bit someone and I'm a vampire. Why am I so bad at putting on lip and making a mess? Oh my god. No, I literally look like I just bit someone. Look, this is a vampire look. I don't want to get up to get makeup remover, but I guess I kind of have to now because I just made it worse. A makeup tutorial, but there's no skills here. But you know, I just want to have brown hair eyebrows. I got that blonde hair eyebrows. And I just want that brown hair eyebrows. My eyebrows do not match my face at all. This is why I just should be okay with my eyebrows, but I'm not. I feel like this looks like really bad right now. But you know, I'm just gonna call it a day. Like, this is the look. It's okay. It's not the best thing in the world. But you know, it could be worse. So I'm just gonna kind of like go along with this, like this is the look. I hope you enjoyed this video for some reason. I don't really know. Maybe you think this isn't too bad of a look. Maybe if you want me to do more fall looks, which you probably wouldn't, but I can do some more if you would love to. I could do like a fall nighttime look. I don't know where I'd be going with this makeup, but you know, I haven't put on makeup in a week. That's why it looks bad. I haven't put on makeup in a week. Yeah, I kind of just forgot what the proportions were for putting on eyebrows. You know, sometimes I just need a sub, but I don't, and that's kind of a problem. Yeah, that was the end of the video. If you want a shout out in my next video, make sure to go to my Twitter and reply to my pinned tweet thing of you turning on post notifications. That make any sense at all? Okay, so that was the end of the video. I hope you liked it. If you did, you should subscribe, and I think that's pretty much it. So, goodbye! Thank you.